Dr. Jyoti Dhangke is from Bharati Vidyapeeth College of Engineering, Pune, and the topic is cell movement in tumor vasculature.
This study about the cell movements in tumor vasculature. Means there are the tumor structure like outer layer. Outer layer is proliferating cells. Middle layer is quiescent cells, and inner layer of tumor, that is necrotic cell, means dead cell. So first here the tumor vasculature means there are another elements, another compounds are there, but in the tumor there is the this cells are there, and this structure in the tumor, then how is the cell movements between these cells? So this is the study about the cell movements in tumor vasculature. Here this is the tumor structure, and another compounds in the tumor vasculature. This is here defining the tumor structure. The figure shows a spherically coherent distribution of quiescent proliferating cells, and which is the ring, a necrotic core. This is the in the center of the tumor. The internal core of tumor is necrotic cells, in reached by a layer of quiescent cells, and outermost shell of proliferating cells, described by Folkman and Hohenberg at and there are many researchers. They describe this structure initially by the Folkman and another also the afterwards there are many structures are discussed about these three layers. In the beginning 1971 Judah Folkman has published landmark article in the New England journal, New England Journal of Medicine, which states that the solid tumors caused new blood vessels growth in the tumor microenvironment by secreting the pro-angiogenic factors, TF factors, means tumor angiogenesis factor. This publication held by the beginning of research angiogenesis and hypoxia. This means the less amount of oxygen. This is a well-known paper which is published by Folkman. And afterwards, 1998, the mathematical model is continued, and discrete mathematical model is described by Anderson and Chaplin in 1998. In the regards of mathematical model, specific cell properties are taken into the consideration at individual level with cell migration, which is the discretized form of partial differential equation. The parameters are examined for the successful making of model are production, degradation, at the individual cell level, cell addition, proliferation, death and mutation of cell at individual level, while keeping the chemicals ECM at continuous levels, were studied by Anderson et al. And here the new mathematical model, which is including the some logistic growth of the tumor. This is studied by in this study, in this new study. Here in this study, the formulation of the mathematical model, which includes five partial differential equations. There is N is tumor cell density, F is extracellular matrix concentration, ECM concentration, U is nutrient concentration, C is oxygen concentration, and A is tumor angiogenesis factor concentration. These five equation, there is my new terms are adding in this logistic growth and oxygen decay rate and nutrient decay rate. These terms are included in this. And to solve this partial differential equations, I discretize this partial differential equations by using the finite difference Euler finite difference approximations. And this is initially its method is described by Mitchell and Griffiths. I use these methods and I discretize this my or partial differential equations. In simulations, the obtained discrete model, which I discretized by this Euler method, so this executed and executed in MATLAB programming, and sales population of dense tumor cell set into the lattice dimensions. For this determination, I have used unit square tumor size, and this simulation code, this running in the 35,000 simulation steps, and which is similar to 1,120 time steps. And here the data I consider as follows in the next table. And after the discretization, I obtained these equations. First was the tumor cell density, then after discretization I obtained this equation, and there are p0, p1, p2, p3, p4, these are the coefficients of about the left, right, and up and down movements of the tumor cell. The next is these are the coefficients which I obtained in the discretized partial differential equations, and after these movements, after these coefficients, to run the code to get the next movements, define the some discrete parameters like PP0, that is P0, PP1, that is the sum of P0 and P1, PP2 is sum of these three movements, and PP3 like this, these sum of four movements, and PP4 like these are the sum of these four four positions are on the grid, or we can say that is these are the probabilities of the cell movement. Then the first equation was that n, and now another four equations after discretizing, these f, c, u, and a. These are another four equations, and this MATLAB simulation, there is here this is visible, or I think this is not visible. I think there is this survival cells, proliferating cells, quiescent cells, dead cells, and capillary points. This I obtained in this coding, and in the simulation results, the simulations are performed using the finite difference method to solve the partial differential equations with appropriate boundary and initial conditions. Initially, the boundary I'm considering here, ki initial the proliferating cell are means a one, and dead cell is zero. On the boundary conditions, these are the values of some parameters. These values of parameters are coefficients which are used in the partial differential equations to solve and to simulate in MATLAB. And after running this 35,000 steps, the simulation results, there are proliferating cells, quiescent cells, and the all cells movements I obtained here, the showing the at a particular time t, at the time t equal to 0, then this center of the tumor, this is very small, and increasing this growing this center means dead cells are increasing with the time, and increasing if nutrient decay rate, which is observed by the cells, and growing the center and growing the this quiescent cells, and proliferating cells turns into the quiescent cells turn into the necrotic cells, or we can say here dead cell. So in the center is moving like this. In this study, it has been noted that the number of proliferating cells, quiescent cells, and necrotic cells are dependent on the time. And as time increases, tumor cells increases, the number of tumor cells increases with the increasing nutrient decay rate and oxygen decay rate at constant tumor cell proliferation rate, as in the result of numerical simulation. At minimum nutrient decay rate, the number of survival cells is tumor survival cells is more than proliferating cells, but the number of survival cells and proliferating cell are approximately similar at the maximum nutrient decay rate. That is the conclusion in my this study. I used these references. These are mainly basic of this study. Folkman, this is tumor angiogenesis on the New Zealand England this journal, and this another part of this study, but it is similar of the steps like this, but here there are another coefficient I studied. This is published in European paper, European journal, tumor cells movements, but there are another parameters I considered. And another, the range of the parameters is considered in this paper. This another paper is my published in Science Direct. That is, this is now, this is in press. This is accepted and online published. This is numerical approach for vasculature tumor growth with glucose and oxygen effect. This is the particular study, and this is a vascular tumor growth. This is the complete this is studied. And if there are any queries, please welcome here, and suggestions are always welcome.